Here's the Hewlett-Packard 255G3, a 15-inch laptop that features something special, one of the most underpowered processors ever made. It is the AMD E1-2100 with a whopping clock speed of 1000 MHz, taking us right back to the early 2000s, when CPUs first started hitting the gigahertz. However, this computer isn't that old. It's from around 2014 or 2015, though if I'm not mistaken, this CPU was introduced in 2013. Which may sound that old depending how young you are, but that's not the problem. I have several older computers that are much more powerful than this. I recommend you watch my first video about it if you haven't already seen it, where I go through an overview of the laptop and try out both an old and a new operating system. The old operating system in question is Windows 7, which ran okay after installing all drivers, but even with a solid state drive installed, this machine still felt like it had a slow mechanical hard drive. So why not put one back in and install that SSD in a machine that actually deserves one, which is basically anything else with a SATA port. But I didn't put the original 500GB hard drive back in there. Instead, I put the crappiest hard drive I have, which is this 80GB one from my ThinkPad T60, a laptop from 2006, which is more powerful because it was high-end. And not only is that older ThinkPad more powerful, but it's also more versatile, because you can install any operating system from Windows XP to 10. 8 and 10 have some driver issues on this particular model with ATI graphics, but modern Linux distributions work no problem. Even Windows 11 works, but only up to version 23H2, which loses support just 1 month after Windows 10. In addition, I found out that this HP 255 uses the same exact display connector as my infinitely more powerful HP 15, a very similar looking laptop of the same age. So I swapped displays. Now my HP 15 has a matte display panel with slightly nicer colors. It's still low resolution, but this kind of connector called LVDS cannot do higher resolutions. Another little thing the HP 255 has over my HP 15 is Bluetooth. The HP 15 came with a Realtek RTL 8188EE card, and the HP 255 came with a Qualcomm Atheros QCA9565. Both of them only support 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi. Only the Qualcomm card has Bluetooth, so I swapped them. And there we have it. This potato machine downgraded even further. Could it get any worse? Let's take a look at software. So Windows 7 is old and unsupported, but not too old in my eyes. What about Windows XP? Well, I tried various hacks included in the unofficial Integral Edition mod, but I couldn't get the installer to start up. Even pressing F7 to disable ACPI just made it either crash with inaccessible boot device error, or it just shut down by itself. Like I said, the problem with this computer is not its age. Windows XP is an older operating system that only works properly on older computers, and this computer is way too new for it. Windows XP is not lightweight. If you installed it on computers that were brand new when Windows XP had just come out, it wouldn't be very fast, as briefly shown in my video about the Acer TravelMate from 2001. There is a legacy option in the HP 255's BIOS, but it's only for enabling CSM and legacy boot for Windows 7 compatibility. The SATA drive controller still uses AHCI. And not to mention, even if the OS could be installed, it wouldn't have any drivers. Not even with a huge SnappyDriver installer driver pack. So how can we make this computer worse? Well, as you know, newer isn't always better. So let's try Windows 8. But not just any Windows 8. The first Windows 8 that came out in 2012. This specific version lost support in January 2016 because its updated version, 8.1, is supposed to fully replace it, just like Service Pack 1 on Windows 7 or version 22H2 on Windows 10. In my video about Windows 8.1 on the Toshiba Protégé tablet, which is 10 years older but barely less powerful than this HP 255, someone had suggested to install 8.0 because newer isn't always better, which I wholeheartedly agree to, but not when it comes to operating system updates. I replied saying that, and for some reason they deleted their comment. Hope they weren't offended. Now I'm gonna get to try that outdated version of Windows 8, as if 8.1 wasn't outdated enough, and let's see how usable it actually is. Yeah, it's still pretty slow. I have no doubt that Windows 8 on this same setup would be unusably slow, while this one does get by with some patience. But you have to understand how outdated this version is. When it lost support, this computer hadn't even left the store shelves yet. The BIOS reports its first use date on April 2016. So of course an updated OS with feature updates until 2022 and security updates until 2025 is going to run slower. And if you had the crazy idea to use this machine for anything serious, you should upgrade the hardware on it as much as possible. While it would still be slow because of the terrible CPU that cannot be upgraded, upgrading the RAM to 8GB and installing a solid-state drive would make it usable a little bit more, even on a supported OS. And you don't just have Windows, you could install a Linux distribution. The vocal minority says Windows 8 could be just as good as 7 if you just install Classic Shell. But that doesn't justify the mistake Microsoft made in porting this kind of user interface to computers without touch screens. You shouldn't have to rely on third-party software to make an OS usable. Back in 2012, I actually daily drove the brand new Windows 8 for a couple months on my 2009 MacBook Pro to learn that stupid Metro stuff. And while I mastered it, I was happy to continue with macOS until I got a newer Windows laptop in 2015 and upgraded to Windows 10 the day it came out. It is better in every way. It's not perfect, but for a newer OS, I have little to complain about. I think I've already mentioned this in a past video. The newer version is a little slower, but you need hardware just a little better than this HP laptop. Nothing crazy. Windows 8 before 8.1 still had the Windows Experience Index, and it's more precise as it goes up to 9.9 instead of 7.9. So let's see how this beast of a machine scores. As you can see, even the slow hard drive has a higher score than the CPU. And the graphics, despite only being integrated, aren't as abysmal as the CPU is. Of course, it's not suitable for modern video games, not that they'd run on this CPU, but this laptop can actually output 4K video over HDMI. It only goes up to 30Hz, but I don't know if it's a limitation of this computer because it's actually a limitation of the TV first. Even if I could plug in my computer that could do 4K 60Hz, it's limited to 30, because this TV is from 2014, when 4K resolution was still a novelty. And very few devices could output that resolution, mostly just Blu-ray players, which wouldn't be at more than 30 frames per second anyway. That's about it, the lowest low you could stoop to with a computer like this. And yet, despite everything, I'd still rather use this than a first generation Apple M1. Thank you for watching. Oh, and in case you still have doubts, even the dog doesn't care about Windows 8.